we're here to play set two of Solforge Fusion. Woo!
Woo!
The new standalone expansion, Stoneblade Entertainment, for Solforge Fusion, the hybrid deck game. Again, just so this is on this record, if this is clean and good to go, and I can throw away the other thing where we did all the talks and all the background information. New to us, new to you, releases on March 23rd. Big thanks to Stoneblade Entertainment, provided us with an awesome display for the Battle for Whitefang Pass. It's got some new cards, got a couple new mechanics in it. We weren't the first to play it though, Lyle. There's been other people checking it out. There was the Fuse Fest put on by the folks at Team Covenant, right? They were the ones who hosted it. Good people over there at Team Covenant hosted an awesome Fuse Fest. And I know Ank, who's in chat, was there. I know Shadow was there, obviously, and all these good people. And I heard great feedback that it was a lot of fun. We talked about it, I think, with you guys a little bit the last time we played Soulforge, since we played Alpha Set after you guys got to play Set 2. So this is our first attempt into Set 2. We've heard it's really cool. Some really cool things, really cool, fun things happening right now. We're also going to be trying out the new Set 2 mod that Shadow has made for Set 2 because of these new mechanics. It needed a couple new spaces, a little bit new organization that we're going to be getting into. And the reason I'm moving kind of fast, Lyle, and I'm good to see you, and it's good to see everybody, is because we wasted time because the internet's brutal.
Yeah, we did the intro. Then that got trashed. We're back. We're very excited to play Set 2.
Yeah.
We're ready to dive into discovering new cards.
That's right.
Figuring out what the new mechanics are and figuring out how it changes the game, basically.
Yeah, we're excited.
Like what new things are going to happen, new types of interactions that we're going to have to keep our eye on.
Yeah, dude, it's going to be sick. We're going to see some new cards. We already popped a deck. We already popped one of our displays. From the display, we got a booster. We each got four boosters, so we'll be opening those over time. Today, we opened one with four half decks in it. Again, Lyle and I are kind of throwing together two that we quickly saw. We don't know half of these new cards. We don't even know half of the new cards.
Yep.
There are some returning cards. So we kind of just put two together, and we're going to hope it works out. So don't expect next level plays or good decisions to be made, because we're playing
it. I'm excited to show you guys some of the stuff that we opened.
Yeah.
And as per usual, Crit Camp style, as we play this game, this first game, you know, it might be a little bit slower than usual because we're going to have to be reading all the new cards and stuff like that, and we're going to want to show them to you and explain what they are. So
before we get too far into that, I think what we should do is we should start with some of these new changes, which is going to pop up here in a second. No?
Yep.
Maybe if I go here. No? Nope. Hold on. Because it broke.
OBS.
Hold on. Chris has got it. Bam. Fix it.
Don't worry. All right.
So what is new in Whitefang Pass, the people might ask, Lyle? One of the coolest things, and if you're in our Discord, Shadow's been in there. And I will say that Shadow dropped some cool spoilers, some images of new cards that were coming out, what the new legendary kind of is. It's like this crazy dragon thing that is insane. Mm-hmm. So head over to discord.gg/critcamp and hop in the Soulforge channel over there. And you can take a look at those until you get to find one. If you want a little bit of spoilery action, I looked at them briefly. We saw some of the new mechanics. We're going to talk about them right now. One of the cool things are these Soulbind cards, Lyle. What's a Soulbind card?
So Soulbind card is like an extra card that you might get in your deck. So this is not guaranteed to be in your decks in Set 2. So this is sort of a possible rare thing that you can get. But if you do get it, you will have a separate double-sided card that sort of just lives in your upgrade pile. And basically what happens is you'll have a card in your deck that references that card, that will bring it out into play or will do something with it. And then once it's out on play, you can sort of transform it. And that counts as like you playing a card, and then you can flip it over or something like that. So we'll see how that really works. And then Shadow will let us know if my explanation of that is wrong or right. I did skim this section here and come up with that little paraphrase. But so basically it comes out. But if it dies or, you know, gets removed from play, it doesn't go in your banish pile. It goes back into your upgrade pile so that you can pull it back out again. So it's just like an alternate style of card, which is kind of cool. We'll see how well that kind of happens. Wink, wink. I may have opened one, so we can show you one of these.
Yeah, wow. Yeah. So I'm psyched we're going to be able to show what this is. I mean, initial impressions without seeing one or understanding what it fully does or the power of these things is that, what it's a level 99's game. Is it, where you had the character card and you could like upgrade them.
I did think about that too. Exceed.
In Exceed, so, you had the powers or something like that, right?
Yeah, like, basically, like you can spend one of your actions or something like that to like to do an exceed to like buff up a thing.
Yeah. Go like 10,000. Like, and I'm hoping that these guys aren't. Or, you know, whatever it does is not like some crazy Commander Magic the Gathering thing where it comes out and it's like, on turn 3, you get to blast for 20,000 damage across your entire. It's like, all right, I don't have any.
Now, you'll see by the example that we show.
Okay,
What kinds of cards.
We don't know. All we can do is speculate. We can only dream. We can only dream. All right, the next thing is Exalting. Now, again, another new mechanic here, and you'll see this in the mod when we go in to talk about it a little bit, that there's now an Exalt row underneath your lane row. I mean, I'll go over here, because we're going to be debuting this mod too. OBS has to catch up with me now that I made changes. So over here, you see this Exalt row on both players' sides, which is pretty sick. So Lyle's got one here, and I've got one here at the bottom of the lanes. So the lanes are a little shorter.
Yeah, and...
Sorry?
Oh, no, keep going.
I was just going to say, I remember before... So they've reorganized the playmat, and you'll see this when we're going here. As you can see, the upgrades are now to the left, your discards are to the right, your decks to the right. They're not stuck underneath there, which is interesting because I remember us originally talking about the alpha mat being having all this unused space. So they've really utilized all the space on the mat now. And of course, they probably knew this was going to happen. And here was us and Shadow and all them keeping their... They're like,
why don't you just wait?
Yeah, if we're going to do something with it, you just wait. Yeah. You just wait. So this Exalt row, what does this Exalt row do? This Exalt row, so basically Exalt's a new type of spell. So you play that out, and when an Exalt is played, it goes into one of those Exalt slots. It does not take up a space in the lane. It takes up one of the Exalt slots in a lane. What that means, I don't know. We haven't seen what an Exalt does.
Yeah, so basically the way that I interpret it, it's almost like... It's like a ongoing enchantment.
Yes, that's what I'm thinking too.
You have a spell, it goes in a lane, and then it's
like
ability sort of
power
persists
or something
in that lane. But that lane is still considered empty if there's no creatures in it, right? So like just because there's an exalt in there doesn't mean that it's considered occupied.
Right.
And so when you play a creature into that lane, you don't overwrite the exalted thing that's there. It's considered separate.
Right.
But if you want to play another exalt in that same lane, you will replace the existing exalt. So you can only have one exalt per lane.
Right.
But you can also have creatures in that same lane.
You know what this makes me think of? The deck I've been running in Snap with Professor X and some lane control. Are we gonna get like a Professor X card in here that says like no creatures can be here anymore, it's done.
I hope so. listen. Are we gonna add snaps?
As soon as I lock down that lane, I'm gonna snap on you and then play Destroyer on turn 5. Done. You're done. Okay. You're done. You're done. You could just do it. You're done. The final thing, and final thing is Slay. Raining Blood. Slay is a keyword that when this destroys an enemy creature. So basically, when you fight and destroy an enemy creature, you can trigger abilities like whatever's listed, Slay, colon, blow up your opponent's side or something like that. Or gain 3 power when you kill a creature, stuff like that, which is what I'm expecting to see in like green Slay decks, which is going to be like battle the opposing creature, gain 6 attack or 6 health or something like that. So that one's pretty cool. And it works with battle, strike, combat damage, all that kind of stuff, which is neat. There's your 3 abilities, guys. We're going to look forward to the Soulbind stuff and transform with the Soulbind cards. We're going to look forward to the Exalt row. We're going to see if we get some of that stuff. And then Slayer. We're going to slay it all down and see what happens. And so, I mean, the next best thing is to just look at some of our decks, right, Lyle?
Yeah. If you want to start with my purple deck, we can show an
example. Oh, he wants to show off. Okay, so let's get into the first decks we open, courtesy of Stoneblade, Shadow, and everybody over there. Lyle's purple deck. The Kneeling Rot's Gatekeeper, guys. The Kneeling Rot's Gatekeeper. Lyle, tell us about the Kneeling Rot's Gatekeeper and what we're looking at.
Okay, first you need to go to who is the one that...
I see you have 2 Soulbinds in this deck?
I do.
You have 2?
No. What? Yeah. So if you go to the Soul Gorger...
Yeah. Soul Gorger.
So the Soul Gorger is... Hold on.
It's a creature.
Oh, I'm sorry. I think it was my blue one that I got confused. But yes, and Soul Gorger is this creature has stealth. When you play a spell, give this +3. And this is my Soulbind card. So if you go to the other side of it, it has stealth. When you play a spell, give this +4 attack.
Huh. Okay.
And it gets a little more buffy. And then the Soul Devourer underneath is... Oh, wait. Did you already show... Oh, yeah, yeah. Soul Devourer and Soul Gorger are the same card. It's just one of the other.
You flip it over. So the card comes out. You have two sides. Soul Gorger and you have Soul Devourer.
Yeah. It's, now go to Devour Soul, which is a spell. That's on the top of the list.
Okay.
Okay. And so this is it. So this is a spell. It says give a creature -2/-2. What if this destroys a creature, you may play Soul Gorger. Now, what we mentioned now is that Soul Gorger just lives in my upgrade pile. It's not in my deck. And so basically, I can use Devour Soul to proc it to automatically bring out the Soul Gorger.
Yeah.
And then as I play spells, it gets buffed up.
But how do you transform this?
I don't know how to transform it.
Do you just say I'm going to transform now? Like for my action, I'm going to... And Shadow will clarify this. Do you say, I'm going to transform this?
This is the question I had for Shadow was now that we have one of these cards, I'm not exactly sure how the transform works. Check the different levels of Devour Soul.
Oh, that's right, because Devour Soul's a spell. Okay, right. We're getting ahead of ourselves. So, destroys a creature, you may play Soul Gorger level 3. Destroys a creature, you may play Soul Devourer.
Ah, okay, there it is.
Okay, so it actually isn't... So you actually have to get the level 3 with Devour Soul... With Soul Gorger, no, Soul Gorger can stay out then.
No, Soul Gorger can stay out, man. But when he's destroyed or removed from play, it just goes back into my upgrade pile.
Oh, so and then now Ankh is saying that this one actually isn't a transform though. Yeah, because I don't see any wording on any of these cards that says transform. It just says play.
Okay. It's just a regular. A regular one.
So Soulbinds are. I mean, so okay. I think where we're getting confused is that when we read this. It's actually two things happening here. You have soul bind cards
and transform. We assume that they were.
Yeah, I thought those were one and one. Right. So they're not one to one. Okay. Some of them have a transform keyword. Okay. So yeah. So what we're looking at here is your soul bind card, which is the first soul bind card, which is awesome. Lyle scored the first soul bind card for set 2. Also, notice the rarity icons have changed, guys, to diversify the sets from each other, which is super sick. More of like a diamondy kind of shape, which is cool.
Then I want to go show you the Evil Lab is under spells.
Yeah.
So this one is an exalt. And so you can see that I can deploy this in a lane and it says deal 3 damage to a creature, I gain 3. So basically I'm a warlock. And then whenever I play a scientist in that particular lane that this exalt lives in, I give it +2/+2, then I destroy this. So it's just sort of like it'll come in. You know, I do some damage, get some health, and then just waits and acts as a gizmo for any scientist that goes into that lane.
Oh, so this is like a 6 scientist deck, like more scientist synergies that are super rad. What?
Yeah. Now, did I check this deck and the other deck that I put together to see if I have scientists? No. I threw this in because it had some shiny stuff.
Yeah, you did not use the collection manager in the last 2 minutes when I was like, just grab a couple that look like they would be cool to play together. Another new card is Shadow Strength. Give a one creature +3 attack. This turn it gets stealth. Okay, that's...
Yeah, stealth is pretty great, and then it ramps up for more attack.
This is free at level 2? Oh my god. Yeah. Like, this is nuts. Yeah. I do want to take a look at Evil Lab and see how an exalt increases. Okay, it just goes up. All right. The damage increases and stuff gradually. Yeah. So nothing too crazy there.
It's solid, as far as I'm concerned. Both of these, all three of these spells are completely solid to me.
I mean, we're quickly looking through this, guys, so we can take a look. I mean, Circe, just so I don't jump over the Forgeborn here that came with this deck, I think none of these are kind of new, right? I mean, I think Shadowcast is more new.
Shadowcast, I think, is kind of new, yeah.
Army Commander is new, or not new, and Soul Siphon is from set 1 as well, I believe.
Yeah.
So,
if we want to look at the last mechanic, if you go to Zombifying Butcher on the left side, this has a Slay mechanic here. So this is a Beast Warrior, and it says Slay, deal 1 damage to the enemy player, and you gain a life.
Yeah, I like
and
that.
And it has a passive that says your other creatures are also zombies.
So you just got a zombie deck.
So yeah, this becomes a zombie deck. If I want to like pair it with something.
Your blue deck that since you're running purple blue is now zombie deck as long as you're zombifying butchers on the table. And he's a 6/5 at level 1.
Yeah.
And what's happens here? Yeah. He goes up 2 damage, 2/3, okay, and everything just 14/9. Great. That's awesome. This card is crazy. Yeah. Zombifying we'll Butcher.
Did I look for synergies for that? No.
I mean, this is nuts. I mean, there's... Oh, we have the Bride of Frankenbaum. I just like the name of that. So we have Frankenbaum's Bride.
Also Slay. Now. You may play a level one spell for free.
Slay, so you may play one or two, and then goes up to play a spell for free on Slay. Did there any new Forgeborn leaders? Yeah, are there any new Forgeborn leaders, Shadow? We haven't seen. I mean, everything I opened, they all look the same. I saw all the same sort of Forgeborners.
My blue one has a new leader.
It does?
Yep.
Mine did. Sunder, Ironbeard, Circe.
Yep, my blue one has a new leader.
And Nova. I didn't get any new leaders. There is new leaders. Okay. What is your... Yeah. Okay, so we're not going to get into every card here, guys, because we're going to notice them as we play them. But you'll see he got this like rare Glorf Glob. some sick new Glorf Glob, the cool artwork. Gets armor and health equal to... What? Give this armor and health equal to the... one of your creatures and destroy that creature.
Oh, creatures and destroy
you absorb
that
it as ooze.
So it's a warlock.
Yeah, you absorb it as ooze, which is pretty crazy. And then this Darkheart Sorcerer Warrior Mage. When you play a spell, deal 2 to... Dang, dude, this guy's like...
Dude, yeah, I'm
your deck is insane.
I'm shambling.
You're this,
shambling
this,
so
all this stuff. They went hard in that.
Keyword.
Yeah, they went hard in the art. So let's look at your blue, since you said it is. Crux Cobalt. There we go.
Yeah,
you're right.
Crux Cobalt here, and it's got some really cool stuff. So Mind Over Matter is a level 2 ability. Draw 2 cards, then put 2 cards from your hand to the top of your deck, and give the next creature you play +4 armor this turn. So it's really just a cycle. Sometimes you get... in this weird position in Soulforge where you have a hand and you're like, I wish I had the Forge, I wish I didn't have the Forge, or I wish I got this later. And this can kind of help you manipulate that.
Yeah.
How well it's going to work, who knows? Precognition is the third level here. Enemy player gets may play a level 1 card for free, but then I get to play a card for free. So it doesn't necessarily have to be
right.
a level 1.
Right.
So that's kind of cool.
Yeah.
And then the Shattered Psyche, destroy a creature with 12 attack power or less, which is pretty great. I'm explaining all these three because this is the Forgeborn I'm going to play
in the game. I mean, this is pretty cool. Like you're saying, the Mind Over Matter, this brings in like the Logos aspect. But we haven't seen any card draw. Like I was constantly like, man, there's no card draw in here. I'm stuck with the 5 cards in my hand. Like this turn's a dead turn. Like I've never had any real good cycle. Just upgrades, right? Like, and I'm like, oh great, next cycle.
And again, you only can use this once, you know, during cycle 2. But it does help a lot. Let's look at the second Soulbind I got here. So Mechmark is the double-sided card that just lives in my upgrade here. This is a spell that lives in a lane. When you play a creature in this lane, give it 5 health. This turn gets mobility 1, then I destroy this. If you want to look at the level...
So this is an Exalt Soulbind, actually.
Yeah.
That's
so
a
again,
duel. You got a duel awesome.
I didn't get a transform one, but I got,
All right, looks like you drew the awesome booster, and I got the baby booster here. Oh, thank you so much, Ankh, and everybody that's been hanging out. Asmati, everybody, thank you so much. It's great.
Yo, what up?
Mechmark 2, when we flip him over, play creature in this lane.
Yeah, when you play a creature in this lane, give it 12 health instead, and it gets mobility 3. So, like, I can just, like... get health and just, like, throw it across the map kind of thing. And if you go to Regia, the Iron Lady, in the bottom, like, creatures list...
Oh, there he goes.
This is what procs it. So a 3/5 warrior with mobility 1. When this is destroyed, play the Mechmark in that lane. So
2 and then 3, Mechmark 2. So she's out to get... Dang it, man. Like, this just looks so powerful. Like, in set 1, I never owned a single legendary. And now in this, if I don't get a Soulbind, I'll be sad.
And a legendary yet either.
Yeah, I'll be sad if I don't get one of these awesome things here. Again, old cards are still coming back in. Steel Eye from the OG days. We got some new spells in here. Another Exalt for you here. We got the Synteta's Laboratory. Play Gizmo Minions. Place your creature in this lane. Play Gizmo Minion in one of your... Oh my god.
Yeah, dude. Just play some stuff.
Dupe Drum? What's this gonna do?
You play a creature with Deploy in that lane. Give it +2/+2, so it's like Gizmo.
Oh
my
gosh. Look at all these words that don't even fit on the card.
it's a lot of text.
That means it's going to do a lot of stuff. And you got Tech Upgrade, which I still don't own a copy of from set 1. This is the card I'm like digging for.
This is the first time I've had Tech Upgrade, I think. I don't have one in set 1.
This card's so good. And now you have it in this nuts deck with the Soulbind, which is also an Exalt. And all okay, well, GG's, I think. All right, we're done looking at
it. I mean, I threw them together, but they may not work well, so.
Well, we'll see. So we'll look at my little baby decks. There's no Soulbinds in mine, nothing crazy like that. I got the Ants of the Insane Notions, though. Like I said, I didn't get any like new Forgeborn. My stuff's kind of OG days. I think Gale Surge is new. Give your creatures 4 this turn, they get mobility 3. I'll be using Sunder as my main, so I'll be running red blue. But Frost Blast, I like that to do some things there, and then Summon the Swarm. Why I picked it? I don't know. I think I was grabbing it because I knew what a Disintegrate does, and I know what a Firestorm does. Yeah. It's AoE. Don't know how I'm going to kill you. Lightning Charge, nothing too crazy to say about this. This guy looked crazy awesome mage that would be fun to use. When you play, you just get spell sprites. Like, I'm just going to try to make spell sprites happen when I play lots of spells, and I have lots of spells. And stuff like that. So I'll be rocking that and getting into some of these things.
He's cool because I feel like the other... I always found that red doesn't do the minion sort of... the minion thing as well as the other three. So he could be really cool to pair with another deck that, like, you want to do minion spam.
Yeah. Well, I mean, what's great is they have so many awesome spells in red that when you do get spell sprites out, you can be awesome.
Yeah.
You can be pretty rad. So Abetting Invokers, we got Shadowbound Vexers. Again, I'm not seeing anything. Like, none of these, I believe, are exalts. Like, I didn't get any exalts in here. Just kind of standard damage. So just be blasting stuff, trying to kill your stuff, which just makes more stuff.
Yeah, go back to your Shardbound Vexer real quick. Because what is that? When this deals damage to a creature, it loses attack instead of health.
Yeah.
And then if it has zero attack, destroy it. It's a very interesting way to deal with somebody.
This is also a... one of those people that go to the other side, traitor. I forget what they call them in this game, but
a betrayer.
So this is a betrayer as well. Is coming in over here. This Metamind Mage from blue, I assume, right? That's the blue symbol. That's the Alolan symbol, right?
Yeah, that's the blue symbol. Yep.
Yeah, so Alolan. It's coming over there. Yeah. I don't know, man. It's gonna be interesting trying to keep up with you because I think you're gonna burn me down. But then I'll be also playing blue, drawing Ionic Scipion Company. I've got Iron Beard here. I can give armor and battle things, so hopefully I can fight you off. I think, when these are outlined, are they considered anything crazy? We got the specimen. I'm trying to find if I have any exalts off the top of my thing.
If I remember correctly, they changed the shape of these things, but yep. Like blue is common, yellow is rare, and then the outline on the color of the outline is the splice on it.
Yeah, it's the bottom half.
Yeah, yellow is a rare.
Right, so like Vidicarus would be a yellow. There's a slay. I got a slay, so that's cool. So if I kill stuff with Vidicarus, with my little
Vidicarus
bow,
is great. Activate, deal 3 damage to creature, then slay, then ready this, then do it again.
Yeah. So I can go pew pew if I manage to survive. I did get an exalt, Guardian's Wall. There we go. I can play a Sanctum. So we got the wall. We got to deploy. You may give a creature -5 attack.
You're playing Sanctum, dude?
Yeah. When you play a warrior in this lane, you may give a creature -5. So I'm just going to make you not do any damage. Is all I can do. It's going to be interesting. But we're going to check out set 2. We're going to see some more of this stuff, guys. We don't want to dig too into it. We didn't want to go through all 8 half decks. Because, I mean, as you can see, we could just... I mean, I'm trying to avoid going down holes with each of these cards and going, man, I'm going to switch it up, like... Would I have chosen these two? Maybe not. I got some cool cards when I quickly looked through my purple and stuff, but again, I was trying to find something that might work. I went damage spec blindly. It's going to be a game, and we're going to play.
Yeah.
Yeah, so let's play the game.
So, yeah, we'll see how this goes. I, like, literally only picked these two because of the shiny stuff, but very excited.
Yeah, so we've got the game here. Here's the new mod, as we debuted before as well. This is made by Shadow, so big thanks to Shadow, and I think they're still updating it, going to change it. I assume the plans are to... add in, you can bring in random decks, I believe, right over here. You can bring in random fused decks from your collection or another user's collection if you know their username. Mm-hmm. And you can test out your decks and stuff like that. I don't think at the moment that we're streaming this is publicly available yet. I don't know if Shadow's still in chat. Maybe he can announce like when they think it'll be. Maybe it's once it hits the street date and people can get some decks for set 2. It'll be there, but maybe he can give us that information a little bit here. But this is the new mod. It has the exalt sections. It still has the power section here, and you'll see that the cards are kind of in different orders, and they're kind of labeled and all that kind of stuff. But it's looking cool. We're going to see how it plays out.
It's looking cool.
I think it's going to be pretty
neat. Excited.
That's all we can really do. We put on some tabletop audio music, and game time. I'm going to hit the start button in the new mod, Lyle.
Hit the start button, dude.
All right, set 2, go! Once again, Lyle is rocking Crux Cobalt V. Team Sunder. So good luck, dude.
Look at this. Look at these beautiful. Look at the beautiful scripting. Okay.
Looks like that worked. Does this still float? Yes. I'll hide that up there behind Lyle. I again, we haven't used the mod at all, guys. We haven't played it. If I need to show the exalt line a little bit more, or if I'm covering up too much, just say so, and I'll try to adjust where how we're looking at this. But I want to make sure you guys can tell what's going on. And it looks like Lyle has the forge, so you'll be first, man.
First, I think I'm going to start with... I'm going to start with this... with this Iron Lady.
Dang, dude, you're coming in hard. So I just got to keep her alive for... All right, she's never going to die. Dang, dude. Man, okay. Let's see. So if I don't want her to die, I just need to make sure you can't kill me.
Die, mage.
Okay, the music's getting intense. It's getting way too intense right now. I'm trying to think here, tabletop audio. Oh, she has mobility? Yeah, great. So could you just get out of the way? Yeah, that's cool. She's just gonna punch me in the face a little bit.
I can just throw her into damage.
I'm trying to read these cards here. I mean, that's cool. Okay. I'm gonna come out with a Spiteforge Sentinel then. Aggressive, stealthy. If this was replaced, whatever. Nope, he's aggressive.
Oh, aggressive, yeah.
Oh yeah, man.
Okay.
Classic.
Just too far.
That's right, man. You punch me in the face, you can punch me a little.
What do I want to do here?
There's some interesting synergies in here.
Do I care about that boy? Do I care about just taking 2 damage to the face? Not really.
I think I just need to get stuff going here.
I think I just need to get stuff going here is what I'm saying.
Well, like, I'm seeing combos that are like, maybe I got the nuts hand too early and I have too many choices, but I can only do one thing a turn.
Yeah, I know. I want to do more things here, but I think what I'm just going to do is throw this boy over here. If this is unopposed, give it +2/+2.
Classic. Okay. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Bill's backseat gaming right now because I have too many awesome combos and I'm trying to spread my awesome.
Wow, so many combos, dude.
I'm trying not to go in one basket right now. I kind of want to spread it out, but I'm assuming that's a bad idea.
Yep. I do not have as many options as you did, I don't think.
Because
opening hand.
I've chosen a lane now, and I feel like I might have chosen the wrong lane, but I'm going hard. All right, I'm going to digitize. I'm going to give this +5 attack. It's my only creature, so now it's a 7/10.
Wow. You went for it.
Yep. Okay. And then where's my banished pound? It's over here.
Yep.
Okay.
All right, so I'm going to take 7.
And I'm taking 10.
Yep.
Yeah, and if you guys need the layout a little different, I'm trying to figure it out. Like I said, I think I need to scoot over a little bit so we can see the health a little better. We'll probably need to flip these eventually. And we've got dice now, look.
Yeah.
Hank saying, digitize the most powerful card in the game. This is a great card. That was a lot of fun.
Well, it's rough now because I'm going to get hit with another 7 because I won't have the forge.
All right, enter. But... give me the forge, Lyle.
Yeah, so I probably should have done something there.
All right, so she needs to live forever. She needs to never die. She is my friend. We've got this dino boy over here at 7/5. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
What can we build up with what these cards are? I want to play new cards. Here's me coming. I think I have played you before with my blue decks, and I just ran sentinels out the whole game and just burned you down.
Yeah.
This is not a new world for us. Just like, he must be played.
Stealth is a thing, you know?
Interesting. So this is a new card. It loses attack instead of health. Huh. That's interesting. So... Huh. I mean, but I like this. Man. Got options.
It's got options, everybody.
All right, so... Ooh, it's so good too. Let's go, I don't want to go that mode. I'm trying to decide on my mode.
Yeah, I hear you. I hear you.
Let's go this. Let's get the specimen out. Right here.
Okay. Interesting. Interesting choice.
311. Classic. I'm just playing the classic cards.
Yeah. Classiques. I hear ya. Ooh. Well, that's kind of annoying.
These are all cool cards. Like, of course I want this out, but I don't think it's going with my strat.
I'm
going to
play this
hurting.
Guy. Emboldening Sentry, deploy adjacent creatures, get plus 2 attack.
Trying to force me to want her dead, huh?
Yeah, and then this guy gets a armor.
An armbler. Oh, I didn't read this whole card. Okay. Okay. That's interesting. So I can't do this there. So if I come in with this, you only have 2 health on that guy?
Yeah, dude. Why don't you not worry about
so
that?
So at the end of a round, if after we battle, Slay will trigger, right? Like
if
I kill a thing with Slay or whatever? Like, I'm going to come out with Kid Icarus right here. Or Vid Icarus. I'm going to keep saying Kid Icarus. So if I kill him now.
No, you kill me in combat, but you can't use an activate ability because it's not your turn. That's right. So if you use a card that lets you battle.
No, I'm saying at the end of the round. I'm saying at the end of the round. So like, I'm going to activate this to do 1 damage here.
Okay.
I think. Is that what I want to do? Like,
yeah,
when
it gets ready, you can't use it until it's your turn.
Right. Now, I'm going to do 1 damage here. You can put the damage back on this guy. I'm going to do 1 damage to her.
Okay.
So my question is, I activated this to do the damage there. Now my turn's done. We're going to battle, though.
Yep.
So you're going to die. Does my slay ability trigger? And then, I can't activate. Oh,
I mean, you can ready, but you can't activate it until your turn.
Right. You're right. I see what you're saying. You were following me. You're right.
I need to figure out what I want to do here. So I get last card here.
Yeah, I have to kill in turn with that 1 damage, right? Which will hopefully work out for me eventually. But I mean, it's such a baby little ping damage that.
Mm-hmm. So I'm gonna take 7. You're gonna take 9 to the face. So I think what I'm gonna do is just for the future. I'm gonna play tech upgrade.
Oh, this card's so good.
And I'm going to upgrade one of my cards since I don't have a scientist in play. I just have to figure out which one I want to do. Let me look at this one really quick.
But isn't this your purple scientist deck? Where's your dude, right? Like, where's your zombie man?
Yeah. All right, I'm going to upgrade Steel Eye Researcher.
All right.
Okay.
He's good too. All right, ending the turn, so you'll take 7, I'll take 9?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
This guy will take 5 damage, I will take 3.
Right. I forgot to battle. And then you die,
this guy
I
will
take
die,
1.
And then you will take 4.
Oh, 4. I go down to 1. That's what.
Yeah, down to 1. Okay. Cool. Cool.
I slayed you. All right, in turn.
It's only upgrade one card because I didn't have a scientist in play.
Right. With tech upgrade, yeah.
Yeah.
Boink.
Unfortunately. Like, I could have played my other dude, but I wanted to give these guys plus attack instead. All right.
Interesting. I wonder if you'll be able to attack Exalt. I'm curious if that will happen. There's got to be a way to remove Exalt. You know what I mean?
Oh, baby.
Wait a minute. Like that for later. Oh, I didn't know I'd have this in here.
Okay, yep. We're going to play Devour Soul. We're going to give Vid Icarus -2/-2. This destroys a creature, so I can play my Soul Gorger.
No, that's right.
And which lane? Oh.
Soul Gorger's coming in.
Sorry, it's not double-sided. So,
right.
Where do I want to put this guy? He is a 3/6 stealth. When I play a spell, give this +3.
Dang. Oh. He got his first soul bind.
Do
now.
I replace this?
3/6. And he'll get. So it would become a 6/6 when he comes out. No, when you play a spell. So if I don't kill it before you play a spell.
Yeah. I'm going to replace the Iron Lady, dude. Actually, no. I'm about to. That's about to pop. I'm going to put it over here. Why is it coming in as a 1/1?
Okay, so it's a 3/6.
Okay, yeah.
3/6. 3/6 Mafia.
3/6 Mafia, dude.
Okay, well, you killed my guy, and I wasn't happy. That's not cool. You killed my guy.
Mm-hmm.
We're about to cycle,
somebody,
right?
I want to play everything on my hand.
So we're about to cycle. I think I should have gone taken another path. This is a late game card. Man, my options are limited, bro. I'm just gonna throw this here, but I think it's gonna level incorrect the way it's not gonna level the way I want it to.
Okay, so that deploy doesn't go off.
No.
But your creatures are robots.
Yay. My creatures are now robots.
Robots, okay. What's my mech mark do again? Okay.
This guy's a Gorger of the Souls. And will become big boy. Or bigger boy when you play a spell.
I think what we're going to do is...
Oh, every time you play a spell, he gets +3. Dang!
Yeah, dude.
Garbage.
He good. He real good. Oh, I have so many choices, dude. Want to do this? Do I want to do this? I have the Forge, right?
Yep.
Okay. All right, we are going to play. We're going to play a spell, Exalt. We're going to put it over here.
First Exalt.
Play a Gizmo Minion. I'm going to play a Gizmo Minion. Whoops, that went over my bash pile. Play a Gizmo Minion. When I replace a creature in this particular lane, I'm going to play a Gizmo Minion in any of my other lanes. And because I played a spell, this boy gets +3.
Yeah, that's crazy. That is crazy. So let's do something.
Yeah, not sure if I'm playing optimally. I'm just very excited about these cards.
So if I do that,
back out. Does that help me?
Okay, so I'm going to come out here with this Allomancer. Bolstering Allomancer.
How many mages you got?
One.
One.
So he's going to come out. I can give another one of my creatures four armor, and I can deal damage to a creature. So I can do one damage.
Mm-hmm.
So I can pop you here.
Mm-hmm.
Let's do that.
Okay, you're going to pop me here.
Or
I'm
going
to get my mech mark out.
Yeah. Yeah. Was that what I wanted to do? And then... Oh, sorry, I did not want to pop you there. Yeah, because this happens. Sorry. Keep that out. I want to hit you here. I want to hit him for one.
Okay.
And that's an activate. Someone's going to get four armor. Where's my armor? Armor. So, four armor to... Come on. Here. And you're down to one health here, right?
Yep. But he has five attack.
Four armor here does not save me, because that's a nine.
Yeah.
Okay. And then we're good. I'm done.
And when does this pop? At the end of the turn.
Yeah.
So that's after combat.
Yeah.
All
so right, you'll take
so,
seven.
I'm going to do two damage to this boy.
Yep. And you'll take seven.
No, I block it.
I'm stealth, though, aren't I? Oh, no, that's only if you're in the back row.
Yep.
Okay.
All right, so I'm going to kill your Allomancer and take two damage.
Two damage, yes.
Yep. Actually, no, I'm sorry. It's stealth, right?
Oh, your stealth. I didn't even think about that.
Yeah, so
I messed
up. You're alive,
Dang.
But you take six of the face.
Dang, I miscalculated that.
Yeah.
I totally forgot that he had stealth.
Yeah, I forgot too.
That guy sucks.
So I'm gonna do one damage to you overall over the armor, and you're gonna kill me.
Yeah.
And then I'm gonna get my mark two out. Yeah. Or mark one. And then I'm gonna do nine to you, you're gonna do five to me, so we're gonna kill each other.
Dang, I miscalculated that because I was gonna pop the I was hoping I would block the damage, then hit you for one and deal with this later.
Yeah.
Oh man, that sucks.
Yeah, baby. Well, now you can block it.
Yeah.
Or you're going level two.
I just miscalculated. All right, level up. Shaking the rust off. All right, so we're level two. I now have Frost Blast, two to each creature.
Mm-hmm.
You can do your draw two card cycle jams and give someone four armor. Plus you have two exalts out. Oh my gosh, you got Mech Mark One and the lab. Oh my God, I can't do anything about those, I don't think. Man. This guy's annoying. But you have to get to, like, level three to get this guy the next thing out, right? With that other card?
Yeah, I have to get the whatever it is that I played to.
Right, so you have to be able
to
keep rocking and rolling, basically.
Yeah, that's true. I have to be a rock and roller.
You got to be a rock and roller. Ooh. What does this guy do? Whoa, that's cool. Oh. Okay. Okay, so I can activate this for each mage I have in play. Okay, so I can do a creature? Only creatures, huh? Boo. I think I'm going to... Because every time you play a spell...
Oh, man.
He's
this is going to be crazy, dude.
He's going to get huge. He's going to get to be a nine, huh? All right, so what I'm going to do before this gets out of hand is I'm going to disintegrate this. Get dead.
Okay.
Because that thing's just going to keep growing in damage and it needs to die.
Yeah.
And that's it.
I have choices.
Boom. Get disintegrated. Alpha set, OG set, Coda. Coda best set.
Coda best set.
Just play Coda. I guess these things have no health. They have no health. They have nothing else. So it has to be like a spell removal or something. Playing the mech Mark 1 also count as a spell and you can't disintegrate? What?
Wait, playing the mech Mark 1 also counted as a spell.
What? Why can't I play spells? I have the Forge. Is that some rule? Did the card say you can't play spells? What? We might have missed something.
Was it when my thing died?
No.
When this is destroyed, play the mech Mark 2. So it played it. And my Soul Gorger was supposed to get plus three attack.
No, that it doesn't say anything about.
No, but should Chris have taken another three damage in the last combat?
What?
Yeah.
For what?
So when this guy was out and he was a 6-6.
Yeah.
No. That was after combat, though. That was after combat. Then what did we? Then what is Aang saying? No, but he doesn't get health. He only gets attack from playing a spell. No extra damage, but it levels
I'm
up.
I'm cheating? How am I cheating? I just disintegrated
him. Hold on. Disintegrate can't damage the Gorger.
I don't see how you guys are seeing that I can't... 8 damage to creature that came... he didn't come into play.
Yeah.
Chris is cheating. Chris didn't read the whole card again.
Wait, but right. I'm supposed to get plus 3 attack from this?
He was supposed to get triggered from his mech Mark 1 on this as well.
Yeah, after the combat.
So he's actually worse than I expected?
Yeah.
Yes, plus 3. Okay. Well, that sucks.
Thanks, Hank.
Yeah, thanks for clarifying that, guys. You caught me cheating. Chris is cheating.
Okay. All right. Did you put the disintegrate back, the upgraded version back?
Yeah. Didn't I? No, I didn't. I thought I did.
Okay.
What did I put?
Okay.
Oh, I put my back in my hand. I didn't put the thing. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, back to my turn. Back to cheating.
I always forget that part of disintegrate, though, that it has to be a creature that came into play that turn.
That's sadness. It makes me sadness.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's go. Okay, so that sucks. Let's just go. Let's go Spiteforge Sentinel over my Venerable Specimen, I guess.
Okay.
So he'll get 5 attack.
Ugh. Okay. Yeah, I'm getting a little hosed here.
Hosed? I can't play half my cards. Apparently. Bah!
So this is becoming a stealth battle, basically.
I mean, this is how I've won in Spyport Sentinels before. I'll just keep stacking the damage up. And then...
Yeah, as I say, I'm staring down 16 damage that I can't defend against because I'm defender right now.
I mean, play stuff in these lanes and get health, apparently.
Yeah... I think what I'm going to do...
He can play exactly 2/5 of my cards. Yes, thank you, Hank. I appreciate it. This is great.
Not that great. This is kind of cool.
It's nice when all my cards say, do this awesome thing, only. But only if Lyle was born in Portland, Oregon.
What? Yes.
What? But Lyle was not born in Portland, Oregon. Well, sorry.
All right, I'm gonna play a synthetic.
Yeah, I saw that too, Bill.
Synthetic Laboratory. So destroy my level 1 version. That's the first thing. You may play a Gizmo Minion. Where do I want to play this?
Doesn't it say when you replace a creature?
I'm gonna play a Gizmo Minion.
Oh, you just destroy wherever it is.
I'm gonna play a Gizmo Minion here.
Gizmo.
Yeah.
All right, Gizmo's out. I'm going to disintegrate that. Just blast you to death. Oh, I guess I could hit him for 1. But that's it. So
Gizmo triggers the mech.
Oh, because it's a spell?
Oh, then I don't want to play Gizmo.
Oh, yeah, he would get 5 health and then destroy this. Well, it gets 5 health and mobility. Ah, interesting.
Yeah, I'll put the Gizmo there. Oh, that's a bummer. I thought, yeah, I guess you're right. It's play a Gizmo.
Yeah, that's cool. Things we're learning about this weird new Exalt row. Okay, can't use it. Interesting. Interesting.
Oh, and yes, this buffs the Gorger. Playing this thing.
Yeah. So I think I'm just gonna go. I'm gonna pop this to destroy this. Do this to 2 damage to each creature.
Okay.
Because I don't want you to buff a thingy here and do something stupid. Okay. I'm defending you here now.
Yes, you are.
You're getting huge. So, am I scared? A little scared. Do I go hard? That's fun. This is more fun. This is more fun. This is more fun.
Mm-hmm.
This is more fun, guys. I'm gonna do the more fun thing.
Oh, so I'm gonna play a Charger Mammoth. Guys.
Aggressive with Breakthrough. When this is replaced, give the creature 4/4. Yeah, and then that creature gets aggressive and Breakthrough. That's great.
Oh, this is bad.
Then I'm gonna activate him to do 1 damage here, I guess. Okay. 1 short.
This is bad.
I'm 1 short.
I'm trying to think if I should pop my thing.
Was that a spell that buffed Gorger?
I don't
Gorger?
Know if there's anything in my deck that would help me.
If he played this, that is a spell, and I think you did give yourself 3. He gave.
Yeah, I did one. Give myself okay. 3. Yeah.
Yeah, I got to remember all these buffings happening over here. Apologies for the eating. It's aggravated eating after the internet issue.
I'm gonna take 20 damage.
This is the way.
If I don't do anything. And that has Breakthrough, so even if I block some of it.
Big ol' 4 damage.
You
gonna throw a little baby Gizmo in front of me?
It's either take 20 or take 16. What a bummer.
Take 20. Take 20 interactive.
Okay. Yeah. I'm just going to put this defender over here. Okay, it looks like I'm going to take 16 damage to the face.
Okay. And then I die and you take 1. You go down to 1.
Mm-hmm.
I dead. And then...
I will take 4. You will take 2. No breakthrough. Okay.
No breakthrough! All right. 20 damage. I just need that 20 damage spell right now.
Yeah, that was a really bad, bad turn. I did not have anything good. All right. Wow. Okay.
Oh. Oh. I think it's because, I think the things are not updating because I did this as a save state, guys, to get back up when the internet was bugging. I think.
Yeah.
Normally when you first load the mod, it will zero out things. It gets a little, it's a tabletop sim funky thing I've noticed before. Okay, I missed out on this.
Alright.
I probably missed out on this.
Okay. There's probably a couple things that I'm going to do here.
Ooh, this thing's back. I can do things. 16 damage.
Okay, we're going to play Devour Soul. I'm going to give this boy -5/-5.
Ah!
Destroys a creature, so I might play Soul Gorger.
But he's already out.
What happens if... Oh, he's already out. You didn't kill him.
Nope. He has 1 health.
Wait a minute. What happens if he's already out, everybody?
I think it's a whiff. I think if I don't kill him, it's a whiff.
Hold on. Let me not do that.
Nothing happens.
Get out of here.
I think it specifically even says that on the Soulbind thing. Maybe not.
Sorry, I thought my Devourer was going to come out.
Nah, man. You got to get level 3.
Yeah.
Nah, man.
Yeah.
Trying to kill my mammoth, bro? No way.
Yeah.
Wow.
Hold on.
Oh, savage, bro.
Savage. All right, we're not doing that. Which means that this upgraded version goes back here. Okay.
That's right. Get that little three. Yeah, get this three version. Get your little Soulbind super booster out of my face, bro.
Yeah.
Your baby deck.
Oh, I could do something interesting.
What are you gonna do? What are you gonna do, huh?
I have to ask myself a question. Like,
ask him. Ask
do I friend. Think you can do one direct damage?
One?
Yeah.
What, to this guy?
Your dude is gone.
You killed
Your dude
my.
Is gone. I can do that.
You killed my. You sunk my battleship.
Yeah. Sunk my battleship.
I mean, I know what I'm gonna do. Although I missed a bunch of synergies.
We're putting this Iron Lady in here. And so I played a creature in this lane, so I give it +5 health.
So this thing's gonna live forever.
And then this gets destroyed. Oh wait, no, this gets destroyed to my upgrade pile.
To your what pile?
My upgrade pile. It's a Soulbind card.
It is? Oh, it's right. Is it?
It never goes to the bench.
Oh, that's right. This is a Soulbind as well as an Exalt. That's right. Oh, that's weird. That's right, because it's a both. It's a double. Nothing out. And this would include playing the upgrade.
And version. Because I played... Wait, no. No, I used the spell that was already out. I didn't play it.
It's like getting used to this. It's like,
yeah, I know. There's a lot that happens here.
All right, so you're now in my way.
Yeah,
you've gotten in my way.
Mm-hmm.
You are in my way.
Yes.
So if I do this, so we're just battling each other. We're not killing each other.
That is correct.
Weird. So right. I gotta get value out of this. So I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna play my first Exalt card.
Oh hey.
Yeah. What is this guy? When you play a spell, deal 2 to a damage to a player, you gain health. Oh, you just damage me whenever you play a spell with this dude. He's about to die. All right, so I'm going to play a Guardian's Wall here. And I can give a creature -5 attack. I'm going to give this -5 attack. So Guardian's Wall is now in. Whenever I play a warrior there, it'll destroy it, give another creature -5 attack.
Okay.
Oh,
these guys are warriors. Cool.
Well, if I play a warrior there, yeah. She kind of stuck here, huh? She can't move her way.
I actually am going to play this Devour Soul that whiffs onto this guy.
Wow.
When you give that -5/-5, the soul gorger part doesn't go off, but this guy gets +3 attack, and then this guy, I do 2 damage to your face and gain 2.
Well, we're not done yet. I haven't done my turn yet, right? Oh, yeah, that's right. You have this.
But I'm doing my abilities, man.
Sad.
Yeah.
All right, so I'm dead. Dang. I liked him. He was nice. I liked that guy.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. How do I want to deal with you now, though? Because that messed me up a little bit and makes me sad.
Yeah, that boy had a really nice replace ability.
I didn't want to do it too early.
Yeah.
Man, I need one more Okay, I guess I have to do this. So I'm coming out with a bolstering Allomancer who was going to replace that thing and get aggressive and breakthrough and get 4-4. So I missed my chance. Do I want it here for later, or am I okay with it here? Because next turn I have the Forge and I'm moving up on you here. This guy's not going anywhere. I'm going to kill this is what's going to die. So I'm going to activate this, but I'm just determining.
That was what I was scared about.
Do I want him here or here? And I'm giving this guy the armor. So I'm just not going to take any damage here.
You're not going to take damage here.
I'll go here.
Okay.
All right. So you take 7.
I take 7.
And then he would go down to 1. She would go down to 1.
Yep.
Okay.
All right.
In the turn. All right. We're on the Forge.
Yeah, I don't like being not on the Forge here.
Oof. Oh. So I have the Forge.
Damn.
Ooh,
okay.
That's cool. What else do I have, though? What else do I have? Okay. What's this guy do? Okay, you don't have the Forge. I've got all the aggro I want. That's cool. That's cool. What's he do? 2 damage to a creature for each mage. Okay, so if this gets destroyed, you get your Mark 1 back.
Yep.
And what does that thing do again? Mark 1, you play a creature in this lane, it gets health.
Yeah.
Gotcha. You're in my way. But I've got aggressive and stealth. So even if you play a creature out here, unless it has aggressive, it's whatever. So I'm gonna do this and kill that before you kill me.
Okay.
Then okay, I'm also gonna do I want this out there? Ooh, that's pretty good too. I'm coming out with this. I'm gonna come out with the Lightforge Sentry. He gets 2 armor.
Yep.
And I'm going to give creatures adjacent to this 2 attack.
Yeah.
You.
This is a bummer. I'm popping this thing.
Oh, shoot.
I'm going to draw 2 cards, then put 2 cards on top of my deck.
Oh, cycle. And the next creature's got arm blurs.
Okay. Ugh. What a bummer.
Coming at your face. Coming at your face. Come on, man. Where's your exalts?
I'm going to put this guy on top, and I'm going to put...
Oh, you're not... Yeah, I can't see, huh? Although...
Yeah.
Did you run it over? Did this thing... Did you just upgrade... Did this thing... Because you came over the thing, did that... Was that the card that you put
in?
Oh,
yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
That was... Try to do it around this way, so that it doesn't...
Got it.
Don't cross this section, because I was like... Something flew out of there. And you're putting them on top? Draw 2, put... Oh, then put 2 on top of your deck. Gotcha. So you can redraw them if you wanted to. Nope.
Okay, yeah, it doesn't matter.
Not looking.
It doesn't matter. It
was
doesn't.
That your Mark 1 anyway?
All right, so I get to play a card. What do I want to do? This is so silly because I'm looking down the barrel of a gun. I don't think I'm going to win this game. I think this is over. But
I think my red-blue aggro gotcha.
Yeah, it's the aggressive stealths. It's too much.
Dude, it's Spiteforge Sentinel, OP, Shadow. Yeah, man, no, we mentioned some things. It was partially our fault on the load, too. It's working great, though, man. It's doing fine. Oh, and I still have my wall out, too, right?
Yeah.
But I have to play a warrior here. Okay.
Yeah, it also doesn't help that, like, throughout this game, I've always been, like, 1 damage short of killing things. So I've had to done some, like, I can do 7 damage to something right now.
This is the way. I think when I show it on air, like, I'm just trying to...
It really hurts me.
This guy's great, too. I got my Lightforge Sentry out. This guy was new. Are there any set markers on new cards, Shadow? Like icons? I don't see like Alpha set. Okay. I don't see White Fang.
All right. We're playing the Bride, dude.
Oh. Play a spell for free. No, there's no set icons. Okay, cool. And what do I have? Okay, if I drop a guy here, I can make someone not strong.
Okay. And then for some reason, the Bride of Rank and Design decided not to go into my upgrade pile, but it doesn't really matter.
Okay.
Where did it go? Where is it? Maybe it did.
How do I want to do this, bro? I think I want to do this. I'm going to do this right. I want to do this right. I'm just going to come out here with a Stampeding Mongasaur. And on deploy, I'll do 5 damage here. And I'll do 5 damage there.
Awesome.
Blam, blam.
Blam, blam, he says.
20, 30 damage That's coming sweet. At you, bro.
Yep.
30 damage. Does Chris actually win that? We don't have a symbol for that yet. Okay. Just curious.
Yeah.
I mean, it's nice that we know from not, you know, just knowing the missed set, but... I know the new symbol represents that's the second set, but I was just curious if you were gonna delineate. I guess it doesn't matter, right, Shadow, because you merge abilities so that they do sort of change. Like, Lightforge Sentry is a new combo thing. Yeah, so it's not that big a deal because all the cards are always kind of unique. They're not set-based.
All right.
Except for, like, Firestorm.
We're gonna play an Evil Lab. We're gonna do 3 damage to this guy. Gain 3 health.
Which guy?
So this guy's dead.
Oh, you killed me.
And then because I play a spell, I do 2 damage to your face and gain 2.
Oh yeah, he's a warlock.
So oh, I think I'm taking 19 damage from you.
No, you're taking 15, 19. Yeah, 19. Oh, okay. I shouldn't have done this.
So I'm down to 1 health.
Oh, I could have done something else.
And then I do 2 damage to this guy, and you do 5 damage to me.
Dollar in a dream, dude. I had another play where I probably could have ended the game, but dang it. I'm giving you a chance.
It's the only thing I could do, dude.
I'm giving you a chance. I could have won the game with a different card, but all right. That was for lols because I wanted to play the Mongasaur.
Dude, this is it.
That was for the lols. This doesn't say creature or player, right? No, dang. Okay.
Oh, this is not the hand I want for this.
Wait a second.
Come back.
Oh, did we just level up? Oh, we did.
Leveled up.
Oh, we leveled up. Oh, man, if I knew we were going to level up. Oh, man, I was like...
Oh. It doesn't matter, dude. This is not looking good.
Okay. Oh, cool. Look, the armor went away on its own.
I need to block everything, huh?
Oh, and I'm not on the forge. Cool.
This is stupid, dude.
Come at me, bro. Are you gonna scoop or are you gonna play to the end? He's gonna play to the end?
I'm gonna play to the end, but this is silly.
Let's go.
Here you go.
Oh, she's out. Oh, you're gonna try to get it. He's coming out with he's flexing is what you're doing. Wait, you don't have you have the forge, that's right.
Yeah.
He's flexing. And I don't have the forge, so I don't have my deploy ability. Acting like you ain't scared.
No, I'm very scared.
Oh, man.
I have 1 health.
What's this do? Okay, so I'm going to pop this to play a Spellswarm minion before I forget.
Okay.
Here. Or actually, no, that takes up a lane, doesn't it? Maybe I won't do that. That was dumb. Nobody has breakthrough, huh? Okay, you have one health. What are you going to do? You have the sweeper? No. What is he going to do, bro? What can you do? What can he do? Okay, I'm going to do this. Shoot, I can't do it. Okay, I'm trying to make you go away. And what does Mark 2 do? It just comes out. It doesn't do anything else but come out, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to do this. I'm going to go... Abetting Invoker is going to come out. Give one of my creatures plus 3 this turn, it gets Breakthrough.
Oh.
And I'm going to give this 14.
Got Breakthrough. Are you still not going to do Breakthrough on me, though?
No, but then I'm going to pop this to hit this for 4 total damage, because I have 2 mages in play.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Because this has Breakthrough now, yeah.
Yeah.
And then I can do 4 here, and that puts it to 6. Conversation how Chris is going to get destroyed.
Bummer. Yeah.
I mean, this is when you play red and you just do face burn, Bill.
Yeah, no. There's nothing I can do. The Breakthrough really kind of is a bummer.
It's great.
Do you want to know what I was thinking about doing? I still would have died because I don't have enough blockers. But I was going to give you a free card here with my guy to be able to do another free card to like put something down here, replace it, and then put more blockers out. I was just trying to survive another turn, but it wouldn't have mattered. So I'm done.
He's done. He's not gonna let me just kill him. All right. So you were gonna do this to get the free cards out. I was gonna go YOLO after you played a thing.
Yeah.
And I was gonna pop out another Stampeding Mongasaur to kill a thing.
Okay.
To kill this off and then just face you down with a bunch of damage.
It was. Yeah. No, like there was no win condition for me. It was just survive. Like, can I survive with one health?
All right. So I take the first set to win. All right. Chris gets the first set to win.
He just got burned down. Aggressive stealth is tough. It's tough when you don't have like good direct damage or good good control in that way.
I was. I mean, I'll turn off this music. I don't know why I hate the music. He was saying how he had no chance. Me? Yes. I mean, well, I just felt like you were going to come out with that crazy combo. Like, here's my red deck I have up here.
You know, it's just shiny things, right? And I you know, there's a couple things that I have never found a good blue-purple combination that works for me. I tend to like blue-reds or actually, I like anything with red. Huh. So blue, red, purple, red, green, red. I'm like really into purple, green. But like blue, purple is the one color combination that doesn't seem to work for me. Although I got to tell you, I love both of these half decks a lot. So I can't wait to find like good pairings for them. But this red with that aggressive blue that you have is pretty sweet.
Yeah, I mean, just to say about what I thought about your Exalt and your Spite, or I keep wanting to say Spite Maiden. It's the Soulbinds.
Yeah.
Like if I go to your deck here, like these Soulbind cards, they're really cool. I mean, what I found was interesting and what we learned and why we want to do this with like the Devour Soul thing, and you go to level 2, if Soul Gorger's out and getting awesome, because 3 attack, if you have a bunch of spells, growing is insane. And if you can get the health, if you can get the health up too with like a green deck, that's going to be insane to deal with. But if you let it live or you just keep throwing stuff to block it, even though it's got stealth, maybe aggressive things, I guess. If you can slow it down and you're just like, whatever, then you have to get to level 3 with your Devour Soul to really bank, you know, to get this out.
Yeah.
So I just burn you down before you can.
Yeah. And Ong said a really good point where the mod doesn't showcase this because they're 2 separate cards in the mod, but it's a single physical card. So if you slow down my Soul Gorger and I can't kill it, even if I have level 3 Devour Soul, I can't play the Devour because the Soul Gorger's already out.
Oh, really? It doesn't just replace it?
No, because it doesn't just flip. Like, You can always replace the Gorge of Shadow says when you play a creature. Oh, yeah, that's true. That's true.
But, yeah, because this says play Soul Devourer.
My Gorge. That's true. I can just replace it.
So, so you could, it would flip. It's kind of like a transform, but not a transform. But you would have to play this card to do it, which just means, like, if you don't get this card.
I would have to replace it first and then play this.
Yeah, and if you don't get this card, then whatever. Or if you can't destroy a creature
with 8/8. But I gotta tell you, I like this because there is always a good reason to play this card. It's not like, you know what I mean? Giving a creature minus is good. It's just whether or not it can trigger the actual thing. Like, can it destroy? Now, I could always destroy my own guys for this as well. So that's great. So I liked this Soulbind more than I actually liked the blue Soulbind. The blue Soulbind felt very, it's the wrong kind of deck that I'm playing, Fuse. You know, if I could get the mech mark on maybe that Soul Gorger, so that had pumped up health, but that's a lot of setup.
Yeah, it's a combo.
You know what I mean? To get it. And so to get this setup is so rough because I have to get out the Iron Lady, and
first.
Then it has to die for that to come out, and then I proc that.
Well, what's nice is you were saying. Like, I was keeping her alive because I didn't want this to proc, but by that time, you're maybe in the second, you've maybe already played level one of this.
Yeah.
And now you're just hoping to get level two with her still out at 3/5, and then you kill her, which pops this.
Yeah.
And pops your other thing, so then you, I guess you could choose the order. Yeah. Then you could put this
in
that lane.
I mean, it's a different mindset, and it's sort of very purple and very blue, right? Purple, it's like, this card is effective, and I can use it now and get gratification from it. And blue is, I am putting this out there. I don't know exactly how I'm going to use it just yet, but it will be good for me at some point.
You're right. I mean, you also have to think we're playing Soulforge too, and the rules are you get basically two actions every cycle.
Yeah.
And so it's like you're going to sit there and use one action to get her out and wait. And now you're going to have to play hope that you have this card and use that action ASAP in cycle one and be like, okay, hopefully I'm not dead by the end of cycle three while I try to proc my combo. Yeah. Watch out. Yeah, but you're right. I mean, like I said it earlier too.
Yeah, that blue half deck that I have requires a lot more reps to get behind. Like, I was making, I would make a play and then realize exactly what I did incorrect as soon as I played, specifically with Syntetta's Laboratory. So the spell at the very top. Like,
yeah.
So this exalt about playing a Gizmo Mating and then replacing a creature in this lane, as soon as I played these out and I put the laboratories in places, I was just like, oh, okay. I know where I need to put these things later to know that I can replace a creature in the lane. It's also difficult when you're being so aggressive that I'm just throwing blockers out.
Right.
So nothing was able to stay.
Well, I was doing originally too. And Shadow will always say to us, like, as soon as you're doing that, you're wasting your time in Soulforge. You're going to die. So I tried to keep that in mind when I play Soulforge now.
I know.
And that's why we started the game, was I was like, you know what? I'm not going to, my first reaction was block you immediately, even with my Lightforge Sentry, or not Lightforge.
I think we both came out of the gate aggressive. I was like,
I will
take the 7 from your face if I'm going to do 10.
Yeah.
And if I can keep doing this, then I'm eventually going to win. But it didn't work out for me. Like, it was just like, I don't have the power. I don't have the creature power. To do it that way.
I mean, Spyforge Sentinel is such a good card, and we've played it before when I've played blue and I've beat you with it.
This card is great.
One of the best cards.
Like, period. There's also the stealthy assassin guy.
Same thing. Same sort of thing, which was great. And also the bolstering this Allomancer guy was pretty rad, and he's new.
Dude, that Allomancer is rough.
Yeah, sick new card.
I've always liked the Allomancer in set one. The bolstering is an interesting splice
him. Yeah. Oh, I guess it's not a new card. Yeah, you're right. But no, I mean, I threw on the old school digitize, which we're saying is good. I didn't take advantage of Guardian's Wall, but that would be great with this Spyforge Sentinel as well. It's a warrior. You could just get like Guardian's Wall into Spyforge Sentinel. It's going to be awesome. And there were some cool new cards like the, where's my mammoth, dude? Spyforge Sentinel over this guy would have been awesome.
Dude, this mammoth? When this first came out, I was like, this guy's awesome.
But this would actually remove my stealth, right? on if I put a Spite Forge over this, it gives it aggressive and breakthrough. I don't think it stacks.
Yeah.
Right.
No, yeah. It is Spirit Forge Shadow.
Oh, I keep saying Spite Forge.
Out of spite. Spite Forge. Dude.
It's Spirit Forge. You keep saying Spirit Forge. No, Spite. Just like we ruined a green card last set. This is the card we ruined this set.
Yeah, aggressive breakthrough and stealth builds up.
Oh, it does stack. Oh, it does stack. Ah, so that is super good. All right, I was thinking the. It would be nuts. It's crazy. Yeah, that's crazy.
I like this Charger Mammoth a lot.
Yeah, this
is pretty sweet.
And the reason I kind of veered towards this red deck is I know I had Firestorm, which I didn't play. I was gonna Disintegrate. I just kept misreading and giving it way too much power. I thought it was just direct blast. You could really get spell sprites going with this, I guess, and give some like Lightning Charge is cool, aggressive stuff.
Lightning Charge is a sleeper.
What is the Scorchmane Dragon thing eventually? Deal 5 to... Okay, dude. Oh, so it's deal 5 to an enemy creature. Okay. But you got to wait this out.
And then, and then the level 3 is an AoE, dude. So
right. Yeah. So I would have had two AoEs. But this one's only enemy creature, so it's great. Yeah. There were some cool combos.
It's so good.
Yeah, some cool new combos.
Red is... blue is my favorite house, but red is my favorite color to pair with anything.
Oh, red's just always going to be burned down.
Like the ultimate second house.
Well, mages are so strong.
I don't have any decks myself that are like where I could say that the red is the primary house, but I have a bunch of decks where I feel like it's amazing secondary.
Yeah. Red does feel good. I mean, it's an easy. It's like playing mage in Hearthstone. It's like you play mage, you burn face. You know what I mean? You hunter, you burn face. You just do damage, and I've loved red in Soulforge because of the cards like Firestorm, Disintegrate, the one that's got the mage synergy where it hits all the things.
Yeah.
Conflagrate. Great card.
Conflagrate is one of my favorite spells in set one.
Yeah.
Like hands down. There's a bunch of red ones that like. You specifically just have to play around. Like, Conflagrate sucks. Turnabout is amazing.
Yeah, like, fight each other. Yeah.
Firestorm is great. Like, there's so many good spells in red, which is why I think it's such a great, like, support house.
So
just fills in the gaps, maybe, of like, what your primary thing is trying to do.
Yeah. No, I mean, I'm looking forward to getting into some more of these set two cards. Like, we only really saw... four of our little half decks here. We saw two blue decks. I mean, it's funny we both played blue, and I like never played blue.
Yeah, I know it is really funny.
But
I'm surprised you didn't play the purple. But I guess I played the purple, so at least we showed that.
Yeah, we showed some of the new purple cards. I was gonna try to pull that up here before we get out of here, guys, since we got to get going here shortly. Apologies for the internet issues at the beginning, sucking up some of our time.
Yeah, I think it's happening to us right now too.
Is it happening? Bit. Are people saying it's happening again? Help, it's happening?
No, but it was happening to me, so I don't know.
No, help, it's happening to you. Yeah, I have no drop frames. I don't know what's going on. This was the deck you just played, right? So, where's my deck? So, I was going to throw up real quick before we get out of here, just so you guys can see what we pulled in our first set to booster.
Let's talk about some
Let's
stuff,
see if anything pops out. I just after a quick look, I did not get a Soulbind in those. Maybe I got some Exalts. I tried to play it as blind sealed as possible. The chunky squashing hermit detail would be the Terra deck I pulled. Nova, like I said, I got no new special Forgeborns. The server, I don't know if it's it might be my end, dude. My internet's been funky today, guys. I apologize. I'm gonna have to check that out. Nova's Judgment, is that new? Give one of your creatures +10, give its opposing creature -10. That may be new. I don't recall Nova's Judgment.
That's old.
But,
I think that's an old one.
Just looking through new cards, Magnivorous Polymorph. No, Polymorpher's been around.
No, Polymorpher's been around.
Slayer has been around. Elk. Stampeding Elk.
Oh, yeah. I would have remembered this art.
Oh, it has Slay with 4 health when you slay things with a Stampeding Elk with Breakthrough. That's cool. We got a new Elk with Breakthrough. 5/4.
Dude, I like this Elk. That's pretty sweet.
Yeah, Elk art's
What's
cool.
Venom Chalice, yeah.
Venom Chalice. Oh, it's an Exalt. Deploy. Give a creature -3 health. When you play a creature in this lane, give it +3 health. Then destroy this.
I like it.
Yeah,
I like it.
So you could kill
a
thing.
It's very green. Very
and then
green
heal
thematic.
Your thing. And the artwork's cool, too. Yeah, this is kind of cool. So it's basically a removal spell, which is kind of neat. And then healing as well. Goes both ways.
Yeah.
So there's that one there. There's my green deck. Nothing really jumped out to me otherwise about this deck that was super new. Not saying it's a bad deck, just kind of going through it. And then I got my Necrium deck, the Coughing Swift Nymphs. Now there is, as this loads, there is one card in here that I know Bill's going to be psyched about that I almost played purple specifically for.
Oh, is it Shambler? You got Shambler?
Yeah, I got a Shambler in here.
Yeah, you got Shambler.
I got the Abyssal Shambler. At the end of each cycle, each enemy player destroys one of their creatures. So not only is it Shambly, but you would have to destroy a creature every time, which is just annoying.
Yeah. Let's go down the list here. What's a Doomdrake?
Yeah, that seems some new purple cards. Doomdrake's old. I remember this. Doomdrake's an older card.
Never had it.
The Spectre's new, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah. When this moves, give it -2 health.
And
it has mobility.
Oh, it has 7 health.
Yeah, so it has mobility and stealth. So that's really kind of cool. I like the flavor of this, right? It's just like, I can move around to proc the stealth better. I just take damage when I do it.
Yeah.
I like that, though. It's got 713.
It gains health.
When this moves, get +2.
It just gets bigger. And this one doesn't lose health at level 2. So it's only on level 1 does it lose the health. And then it just neutral, and then it actually just will keep living. So it's supposed to fly around.
I like that a lot, dude.
Yeah, that's really cool. Excuse me, I gotta...
Yep. All right, what else we got here?
My dusty basement. And then another thing with the Arrogant Slime is old. Let's see, or from set one, the Glorb.
I didn't get to play this guy, but I kept looking at him. I was like, this is cool.
Yeah, you had one of these.
Yeah, because it's like I finally got him at the very end of that last game where I had that 7/12.
Yeah.
You know, lady, and I was like, I could make this guy 12/12, but like I also need 4 blockers.
I mean, it's super cool that it goes up that amount, right? If you have someone about to die and they have like 5,000 attack but like 2 health, the opponent is like, whatever. It's plus, not set.
But give this attack and health equal to the health of one of your creatures.
Attack and equal to health? Yeah, it gains on the 2/2, right? Am I reading that wrong? Like, I thought, like, if you kill a 5/5...
I thought it would just replace it. So if I had a 7/12 creature and I played Glof Glorb, I thought it would be a 12/12, and the other guy gets destroyed. But is it really supposed to be a 14/14?
It, like, absorbs that creature.
Oh, 14/14. Oh,
wait, what? Am I reading this wrong?
Even better than
so if this is a 2/2 and I kill another 2/2, I destroy the other 2/2, this becomes a 4/4.
Yeah, it becomes a 4/4.
Yeah, so I'm reading that right.
Yeah.
Okay, that's how I was reading.
You were reading it right. I was reading it wrong.
Oh, okay. That's how I thought you were reading it. No, okay. Yeah. No, that's pretty awesome. But does it change? This gives it twice the amount that the creature you destroy. Okay,
very
level
cool
3.
Yeah.
This is pretty sick. At level 3, it just gets nuts.
Yeah, I know. That's why I was
cool.
Like, I never saw the level 1 until the very end, and I was like, he would have been a cool guy to that top.
This would have been cool if it went like 1 time, 2 times, and then 3 times. I'm sure that had to have been
one time.
Yeah.
The... 2 time.
How many mics do you rip on the daily? Many money. Then we got the Doom Butcher is the guy that we were waiting. Like, I got a Doom Butcher as well, right? No, you had a vampire or something.
I got a Butcher. I don't know if it was a Doom Butcher.
No, yours made more zombies. Yours made everybody zombies. Mine,
yes.
I can destroy a creature to deal 5 to a creature or player at level 1.
Oh, dude, your Butcher's better.
7 to a creature
like
or player.
Butcher.
And then deal damage equal to its attack to a creature or player. Oh, yeah. Deal 3 to an enemy player. Ew. Oh, this is like the Vampiric Reaper I had. Because it deals damage and gains health.
Yeah. These boys are
Butcher
Vampiric
Goro.
Slayers.
Yeah.
And I like it.
Dude,
Butcher Goro, totally.
Yeah, Butcher Goro. Dude, the fact that when you do damage and gain health in purple, oh man, and you get to do the deploy. I mean, it sucks you got to destroy a creature, but on deploy, but if you're popping out zombies with Zombly Mommy or something.
Yeah, I was going to say, I was like pair it with somebody that's rocking minion generation, and who cares?
Oh man, right, that's
let's
super
go to your
cool.
spells, because those are two new ones that I've never seen.
Yeah, Red Wasteland Exalt. You may destroy one of your creatures. When one of your creatures destroyed before combat, give your creatures in this lane 2/2.
Okay.
5/5, 5/5, and then something becomes free. Destroy Wasteland. You destroy one of your creatures to play a card for free at level 2. And then this is a 1 or 2. Destroy a 1 or 2 creature to get that.
Yeah.
Cool.
Oh, Shadow's got some combos. It says, take your level 2 Krogius, Glorf Glob it, and then fling it out of your opponent.
Yeah, level 2 Krogius. But I thought, because level 3 can't be hit by spells, right? Only level 2 can be destroyed by spells and stuff, because Krogius is OP as heck at level 3.
Yeah, okay. level 3 like, is just, you can't do anything to it.
Yeah, what is that? Oh, 014.
Oh, level 2 was 014, that's why.
Yeah, that's savage, dude. And then this had 2 exalts in it. I didn't realize that. So Runescarred Pit, you may play a zombie brute in this lane. On level 1, you get a brute? What? When you play any one or two,
when you play a level 1 or level, wait, a level 2 or level 3, you may play a zombie brute in this lane.
So what happens here? You go zombie brute. When you play a level 3, when you cycle it, you get another brute. So you just keep popping brutes with this thing. When you play another pit,
dude, this pit's amazing.
It's just brute generation. You get 2.
Dude, it's just brute, dude.
Wait, so you get 2 brutes every time you play it, technically. Because you play it on deploy.
No. Whenever you play.
Yeah. It just keeps cycling because you get it on deploy, and then because you played another one, you may play a zombie brute in that lane.
Oh, but yeah.
Assuming you don't have one there already.
Oh, my God. It's like zombie spawns, dude.
It basically, the zombies never die.
Dude, it's like we're playing Zombicide, and the pit. It's like they're making pits, dude.
Yeah, it says one brute, so it does, so, oh yeah, because you can have multiple, because you have 3 levels of this, it's not the same card. I'm thinking of it as your Soulbind.
And they just stay in those lanes, and then you play another one in a different lane, and then you get
you could just
to
keep putting brutes in place. Oh my gosh, brute generation?
Dude, this purple deck is so good.
Yeah, so like, you do Runescarred Pit with Doom Butcher? And you can just kill the brutes and then not worry because...
Dude, you should have played this purple deck.
I know, I was going to. I don't know the power. I don't know the power. Oh, dang. Sad.
Dude, that pit's amazing.
I'm glad I got a good, sick purple deck. That's my luck. Well, before we get out of here, let's look at what the other two...
Yeah.
I want to look at Lyle's other two...
That's part of the lore.
We'll look at Lyle's other two decks here. So, what is it? We have your green.
It's my red and my green.
Okay, so that's your purple. We're just going to pull up his red and green. Hope you guys are excited about these things. Yeah, did Zombie Mommy make set 2 Shadow? And what's great, guys, if anyone's curious, if you haven't played... This is like Keyforge. You can play both sets together. It's not like you have to play set 2 only or set 1 only.
Yeah.
You can meld them. The Cthunes of Bellowing Dream is your green deck.
Yeah. I finally got a Krogius, dude. So
this is my
first Krogius.
Lyle got a Krogius here, guys.
I got a Krogius. I had to wait for set 2 for it, but... There he is, the Bill special.
But you have a Glob, so he's saying you could do this combo.
Yeah, I was going to say, I can do the Glob thing.
You can do the level 2 Krogius combo. It's 0-15. He said it was 14. So there you go.
Yeah.
Plus you gain crazy health.
Get some health.
Yeah. What's new in here, though, in your green? Twin Strength spells.
I got Twin Strength. Look at these bears, dude.
Yeah, dude. It's you and me, dude. We're going to cosplay as this at PAX Unplugged next year.
Yeah, dude, we're going to cosplay as this. Give up the 2 different creatures, +2/+2.
We'll just walk around with daggers dressed as bears. I mean, this is very on brand for us.
Yeah, well, it's a bear and a cat, right?
Is it a bear and a cat?
Or is that 2 bears?
I think it is like a bear. It's like a bear and a cougar or something.
Yeah.
Shadow's saying it's an Oxidon? What? Also, what?
Torgmai is I am Groot backwards. Easter egg.
There we go. Let's do crit nose on that one. Twerg my guardian. Yeah. No. Oh yeah. TM.
Yeah, warrior.
Yeah, so what's this Oxidon Rager thing? When this has no adjacent creatures, destroy it?
Six breakthrough. No, just my god, okay. No, so he's gotta have a buddy.
Yeah, he's gotta have a buddy to rock. That art is crazy. It's like a little lizard thing. Then you had the combat version of the elk. So it's 5/5, 8/8, 12/13. Okay. Slay, gain health. Roaring War Tusk. Yeah, I remember him. Grove Mother's great, too. I mean, Grove Mother's always awesome.
Grove Mother is great. I have a deck with Grove. I have one deck with Grove Mother, but it doesn't play very well. And I always like the Pack Masters. The Pack Masters are always great.
Yeah, Sharpblade Behemoth. This damage equal instead of deals damage with its health. Oh, okay. Instead of its attack.
Wait, this deals damage with its health. Interesting.
So I wonder if you get a spell that can like fight with this. So this is like an 18/18.
Dude, I wanna glorb this thing too, dude.
Yeah, you could just buff this thing up with health. You twin strength this thing.
Dude, I I played the wrong deck with my purple deck.
Well, so I guess putting attack on this guy means nothing, really.
Yeah.
Unless you use it for a spell or something. Interesting.
Yeah.
Yeah, so there you go. There's your green deck. That's pretty sick. Yeah, congratulations on getting the Krogius OP. Broken Krogius card. So you always win games. Yeah, you can buff the health, right?
Yeah, buff the health.
He's instantly killed by the Vexen.
Korok, hey, he's got some... I think there's a new Forgeborn thing. Earthen Flats. Is that new?
Where's Earthen Flats?
Give a creature plus +4. You may have a battle an enemy creature.
Oh, over
here. Straight up battle.
Okay, cool. That's cool.
Yeah, I like it.
Nice,
I like it.
Nice. Okay, so then we have the Blitzing Breaker. Is he new?
Ability 1, Breakthrough, but he's a 4-1. Give another one of your creatures plus +4.
Now, he's the Yeti. This guy was before, right? I thought it was called something Yeti, though. Is the art just similar to the other Yeti?
Yeah, I think the art's similar to the other Yeti.
Yeti's just all...
this seems new.
Okay. Just kind of looks like the other Yeti a little bit. Remember Warhound? I want to say that's...
I feel like that's older.
Right? We've seen that before. Stormling's seen that. Solemn Master is what
it's
I was
blitzing.
Rocking.
Yeah, Shadow says Blitzing is new, but Breaker is old.
Oh, okay. So it is similar.
Solemn Master, when you play another mage, you may get a spell sprite minion. If it has no adjacent creatures, give it... Okay.
I kept wanting to play this guy, and I didn't use him.
Yet another deck with Thunder.
Thundersore, you love Thundersore. And then Herald of Fury.
Every deck with Thundersore.
Look at this dude.
You may deal 5 damage to one of your creatures, then if that creature is not destroyed, I may play a level 1 spell for free.
Free spells, not destroyed spells. Play any spell for free at 3.
Okay. And then Rolling Shard back. When it's dealt non-combat damage, deal 2 damage to all enemy creatures. When this moves into a lane with an opposing creature, deal 2 damage to that creature.
Huh.
Non-combat damage, so that's like if when you get pinged by like the Allomancer or something,
or like you
right?
hit it with Herald of Fury.
Oh, right. Yeah.
You can then deal damage
But yeah, it would kill him.
Yeah, and it's a sweep though.
Yeah.
You got Burnout, Promoto Slam, and Stampede. Stompede.
Oh yeah, Stompede.
Deal 2 damage to this damage, ignores armor.
Deal 2 damage to a creature, this damage ignores
armor. Oh, Dino Deck. It's a Dino Deck style.
Oh, okay.
Repeat it. For the above ability for each dinosaur you have in play and ignoring armor. That's great. And then Solemn? Oh, Solemn is the new thing. When you play a mage, you may play...
Yeah.
Okay. When it has no people next to it, he gets big. Gotcha. And it's Stompede.
Yeah,
I said it right the first time.
Solemn is I want a buddy. Yeah.
Yeah. Solemn? Yeah. Yeah. I don't want a buddy. No, he wants to be Solemn. He wants to be by himself.
If you have no... Oh, yeah, he wanted to be by himself. Well, who's the other guy that wanted a buddy?
It was the other thing, the buddy guy. But yeah, Stompede, that's cool. Loving the flavor of new cards, says Bill. Great work, Stoneblade. Yeah, no, this is all cool, guys. And this is only 8 little half decks we've dug into. We've got a bunch more to get into. Hopefully the internets will play better with us next time around. And we can do this a little bit more cleanly. Big thanks to Shadow, the team over there at Stoneblade, Lucas, everybody. You guys, like Bill said, yeah, this is cool. I'm liking the new layout of the board. I'm liking the idea of the exalts. Oh, thank you so much, Shadow, for the sub. You've done already helped us out. Support. We really appreciate you guys over there at Stoneblade. I like the display. I like the artwork. Everything's cool. I'm glad that we're seeing a lot of cards that we're familiar with and abilities that merge together. We apologize for the slower thing as we're discovering this and kind of always shaking off the dust a little bit and kind of we're learning another new set with it. We want to do better, but now we've already seen the madness. I mean, what I like about Soulforge is that you quickly all of a sudden see, man, I should have played that purple deck, or what you want to play next game, right?
Yeah. It's there are aha moments with this game that I think happen to me every time I play.
Yeah.
And I love that feeling. And so this game is now a game that I usually play Keyforge on Thursday nights on my FLGS, and one of those nights in a month, we're now playing Soulforge. It's basically the Keyforge group also playing Soulforge. We got enough people very interested in this game. And because we're all sort of like, you know, still learning and like sort of figuring out set one, it's been really, really interesting playing, like, because you'll have those games and then like after the game, you'll have like this intense conversation about like, didn't even realize that combo. Oh my God, when you did that, it just totally destroyed me. Or when you did that, that was crazy. That like that interaction worked in a way that I didn't think it was gonna work. So it's been really cool to play this game and sort of discover new stuff. And the new mechanics, There's new mechanics, a couple new abilities for Forgeborns, and new splices as well. Like, it's a lot to take in, but it also feels pretty great.
Yeah.
Not overwhelming. So
yeah,
really excited.
Yeah, I think you're right. I would just second that opinion that when you see that new, oh man, Exalts, now we got Soulbinds. It's always fun to play it first, right? Like, when I first saw it, yeah. I was like, all right, there's going to be a lot more stuff happening, and you're going to be OP as heck playing two Soulbinds against me because I have no legendary feeling, right? Like,
yeah.
But they're after one game and minimal knowledge of how to use our combos with the Soulbinds and the Exalts, it doesn't... those ones you play don't feel like they're just OP. They feel balanced and
it's also the
stuff.
Wrong combination. So again, it's just like I would have rather played, I think, my green deck with that purple deck.
Yeah.
I don't think I'd still have to figure out what to do with the blue deck. The blue deck is super, super thinky. And so I'm gonna have to like really get some reps in on that stuff.
Right.
But we looked at your purple deck and we're like, oh, that's a lot more OP than when you first opened all four and you're like, I don't know which to play. I'm going to put these two together. And then, like, the further we dove into those cards, we were like, okay, actually, that's, like, pretty freaking sweet.
It's a fun it's fun new discovery, and the games are always different because you never draw all the cards in this game, which is great.
Yeah.
And Shadow's clarifying, they try really hard not to avoid power creep. We just want new options, not buy this new stuff or suffer. Right. You don't want the... buy the powerful stuff. I see what you're saying there. Yeah, like, you gotta go. I mean, you totally should dig for Shamblers and and Krogiuses and those cool cards, but they don't guarantee you a win, right? Like, I mean, I always hearken back to the Alpha set and the first set, and I know we're playing the second set, but Drix was huge. I still don't own a Drix, another card in blue I don't own. And everyone was like, oh man, people are playing double Drix decks and it's gonna dominate. Double Drix didn't win the tournament. You know what I mean? It just didn't work.
I gotta tell you, like, I have a couple of decks with Drix that I have brought to my FLGS, and like, I will just get like stomped by like people that come up with like other stuff.
Right.
It's really kind of cool. That's why I also like about it. It's just like you have a deck combination that you think is really great, and then we play, and it's just like between my collection and your collection, it's like they might be doing well. But then I take that out into the wild, and it's like, it's not as consistent as I thought. It's crazy.
Yeah. I mean, you never know. So you got to keep playing them. Keep stats going. People in the community are doing cool stuff like that. Be sure you post up what you guys pull. Go into our discord.gg/critcamp. Show us what you get. Once again, the Whitefang Pass booster set here. This standalone expansion right here from Stoneblade is coming out March 23rd. So a couple weeks from this stream. It'll be street date. You can buy this. And Shadow confirm, I believe you can pre-order it some places. I don't know if you can pre-order it at Stoneblade. But I was Googling around for some information. I saw people posting potentially ways that you could pre-order this from various vendors on the internet. So you can reserve your copies now.
Talk to your person at your FLGS.
Yeah, right. Get them to kind of like get into it a little bit.
I'm sure they have some knowledge as well.
Yeah, do what Lyle's doing and sort of get some games going and call Lyle to fly him out to your FLGS to teach games of Soulforge.
I gotta tell you, it is a little rough. Like it takes a bit to teach. So now that we have a good like solid like eight people that play the game, it's much easier to teach like the one or two that trickle in every week. Where in the beginning when it was just me and Cam, we were the only people that knew how to play the game, and there was like six or eight people that were like trying to figure it out. Like we're like only like two of them could play with me and Cam at a time, and so everybody else was kind of just shouting questions at each other from like across the cafe.
Yeah, and I do just want to say
crazy.
The mod's a great way to learn. Charge Plated Podcast Shadow says did a great job. Links in the Twitch chat there. I mean, feel free to throw that into the Discord as well. And check that out. You can feel the magic of it, says Dark Black, as soon as you play it. Yeah. And I'd say hop on Tabletop Sim. The mod is free for set one. Shadow, can you confirm when set two, the mod we use tonight, will be publicly available? Because I think it was private right now, is it not? Or is it publicly available now? You might have unleashed it, but is there a date that you're aiming for, like the 23rd or something? I think Ankh may have said 23rd earlier, but I don't know if he was talking about street date. It's public, but hidden.
Sense.
All right. Well, let us know if we can share it in the Discord. I'll wait. I'll let Shadow take the lead on that.
Yeah. We'll let Shadow share it on the Discord if he's feeling saucy enough to do so.
Okay. Shadow says
you can share.
Oh, he says we'll share. Okay, so we'll put that link in our Discord.
We'll link it in our Discord channel.
Yeah, thanks. And be sure you guys check it out, and it will replace the original mod on the 23rd. Okay, good to know. So if you guys have the other mod that's available now, that will go away, and they'll focus only on the Set 2 mod, which makes sense, I guess, because Exalt section is a lot better. So, yeah, it's great. It's great. Yeah, I'm glad people are enjoying it that are hopping in the chat and giving their opinion. I hope you guys enjoyed this. Apologies again for the internet issues. I think I did start getting some more gigginess and sticking with us as we learn the game a little bit more.
But hopefully that happened after the gameplay was already completed.
Yeah, I hope it did too. I don't know what's going on. I had some internet issues last night, and obviously it's still dwindling.
And I had internet issues a few days ago when we had a big windstorm.
The internet, man. It's how we live our lives now, and this is the way it is. This is the way.
This is the way.
This is the way.
It's true. Listen, I had back-to-back days where I had an electrical blackout for a few hours, and then I had internet blackout after that, and you kind of forget how much of your life these days is just controlled by both electricity and internet.
My kids lost their minds last night before bed when they could not get on YouTube and Netflix for 15 minutes. It was pandemonium in my household. And I think it was the internet, plus my daughter turned off the Wi-Fi button on my router. So,
sweet.
Two-year-olds in router use, they're not IT techs yet, but they think they know what they're doing when there's flashy lights. So, yeah. All right. Thanks, guys. Thanks again to Stoneblade. Thanks to Shadow. Thanks to Soulforge Fusion. We guys, check it out now. Hop in our Discord. We'll put the mod up there. Show us what you get. We'll look forward to playing this more as our schedules tighten up a little bit more. And we'll see you next time. Thanks for the support, guys.
Bye. And the Forge be with you.